pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening and welcome to the 22 September 2014 Selectmen's Meeting. Roman one, public comment period. Public comment, please, sir.
Art Moody. I think this time of year that it might be a good idea to recognize our heritage. It was 375 years ago this month that the town of Hampton became the town of Hampton from the town of Winnicott. The Massachusetts Bay Colony was the one that granted the plantation here in the fall of 1638 is when they first settled. And there were three members of the court in Boston, Puritans, that did all the decisions until the spring session of the General Court, Governor Bradford and company in Boston granted town status to the town of Winnicott in the spring session, 1639. And then in the fall session, it changed the name to Hampton, of course, the Reverend Batchelor, where he was from and some of his religious followers. Hampton in England, in southern England, later became Southampton because there was another Hampton in England. Concomitantly with that, I'd like to bring up the issue of the town report last year, 2013. In October, it was the 375th anniversary of the permanent settlement of the town, but the town report should not have had the number 375th annual report. It should have been 376, because they counted the first year. When they started numbering town reports in the 20th century, they had the first year, 1638, as year one. And so even our 350th in 1988, the town report was, for 1988, was the 351st town report. But last year, they repeated the number from 2012 town report, making it double serial number. And the town report is an important record that you have to keep the hard copy. You can't just microfilm it and file it. You have to keep the hard copy. That's how important it is. And that serial numbering has been correct since about middle of 1940s. They didn't start numbering them until earlier in the 20th century. And I would like to, I have a feeling that the next report for 2014 is going to be 376. So you'll have two numbers for two different town reports. One number for two different town reports, and you should do the numbering for this year, 2014, the 377th, to make up for that error, that tampering with the town records by putting the same serial number from the year before, which was wrong. I was on the Records Committee, Municipal Records Committee. It never came to us. And I talked to the last fall's chairman of the board, and it never came to the Board of Selectmen. I think in order to have correct serial numbering, you have to go jump a year to make up for that double counting. There has been no errors since 1944. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Further public comment? Seeing none, I have some housekeeping before we go to Roman 2. Chief Sullivan is serving as the town manager during Mr. Welch's absence for vacation, and Selectman Griffin is committed elsewhere and has informed everyone earlier today that he would not be available to attend this evening's meeting. Announcements and community calendar. Selectman Wilson.
I got one. We always seem to acknowledge our great job the police and fire departments do in this town and public works. But the town manager received a letter this week, and I'd like to read it. Dear Mr. Welch, on August 16, 2014, at approximately 3:30, my wife and I were walking past the Hampton Lifeguard Station near the Seabrook Beach Line. We noticed that the lifeguards were not at their station. A few minutes later, we were walking towards the rocks. We noticed a lifeguard, Aaron Kelly, rescuing a four-year-old girl. This girl, along with three other girls, had climbed over the rocks and was stranded due to the turbulent high tide. The little girl appeared very frightened, yet Aaron seemed to be calming her down and was bringing her out of harm's way. This girl was in imminent danger by being swept out to sea. Aaron suffered several abrasions to her lower legs, but due to the heroism of the lifeguards on the duty, this tragedy was prevented at Hampton Beach. Kate Kazaza, Max Ruffert assisted helping the three other little girls out of the water, and the four little girls were out of the water all alone without adult supervision. Being a retired EMT firefighter from the town of Salem, New Hampshire, I have been on several rescues in my career, this being a job done well done by all three lifeguards on duty that day. My eyes are having lifeguards stationed at Hampton Seabrook Line is of great importance due to the above mentioned. Congratulations to Aaron, Kate, and Max for a job well done. It's from David O'Brien.
So. Very nice.
Thank you. Selectman Riddell.
I'm all set.
Sullivan, any announcements? Thank you. Roman 3, consent agenda.
Also move, Mr. Chairman.
A second.
All those in favor?
Do we want to clarify about the parking fee?
I've reviewed it. I don't see any need for clarification. There's a motion. Do you need to discuss anything?
Okay.
All those in favor? Unanimous. Roman 4 appointments. 1, Donna Bennett, public meeting. Good evening.
Good evening. I've brought my esteemed deputy with me to just sit in. Okay. Help me out a little bit. We've discussed there are 6 properties that are up for deeding for this year. We've discussed them with you. We are making recommendations for items 4, 15, and 18 that we accept a payment agreement with them. They will sign that, you will sign that, and everybody will get a copy. And we're also recommending that we waive the deeding on item 4, 15, 16, 18, and 19. Those waivers will be prepared over the week, and I believe you'll get them next week for signature. And just so the public knows that when you waive a property from the deeding, it does not take the taxes away. It does not take the interest away. Those do continue to accrue. Deeding will come up again next June. So if anything, any reason that a payment agreement is defaulted on or anything changes, it can always be, the deeding process can always start again with notification. And we are also recommending that we accept the deed on item 17.
Thank you. Questions?
So this is an ongoing process, basically.
Yes.
It can turn over after several years, and different people may need help sometimes. And it's just, this is a routine, pretty much, matter for
right.
your office.
Right.
Okay.
And we're willing to work with all of them to
right.
get these payment agreements
right.
up
Mr. Breiter?
Nothing.
Mr. Waddell.
Nothing.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, I'll move that we accept the recommendations of the tax collector to accept payment agreements on items 4, 15, and 18, and to waive the deeding on items 4, 15, 16, 18, and 19, and to accept a deed on item 17.
A second.
Second.
All those in favor? Unanimous. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much.
Good night. Well done. Roman 4, number 2, Mike St. Laurent, Loco Sports, Alpha, Smutty Nose Half Marathon, sir.
Oh, boy.
Good evening.
Good.
Thank you for allowing me to be on the agenda. As we spoke last time we met, I thought it would be a good idea, and the board did as well, that I come in to let the public know about the race coming up. The race will be Sunday, October 5th, and this is a Smutty Nose Rockfest Half Marathon. It starts at 8 o'clock in the morning. But before then, a week before, we'll be posting these types of signs up on the roads. There'll be about 50 signs all around the place, and each sign will have a different time designated for the area that it's in. And besides that, there'll be, I don't have the postcards yet, but there'll be 5,000 postcards distributed to every residence and every business east of Route 1. Those will be going out probably Wednesday or Thursday and arriving in people's post office box Friday or Monday. Besides that, for the runners, we printed out 5,000 of these sheets to give to everybody. It says, spectators, please stay off our roads. Stay at the beach and enjoy yourselves and watch the race there. So we believe that we'll be able to keep a lot of people off of the streets in their autos and enjoy the time at the beach. So for people at home, the race starts at 8 o'clock. It spends about 3.5 miles going around the beach district twice. Then it heads north on Route 1 on Ocean Boulevard, excuse me, Route 1A, up to High Street, where it takes a left up to High Street all the way to Little River, where it takes a right on Little River. It joins Woodland, and then it goes down Great Gate to all the way over to Huckleberry and comes back on Route 1A and back to the seashell. This year, the race is only a half marathon. We expect most of the runners to be done by 11 o'clock in the morning or even earlier. We have a time limit on it to make sure we don't have a lot of extra stragglers in the road. And we'll be working diligently with the chief and the police to have at least 25 police officers out there and electronic signs and plenty of safety marshals and everything else. But thank you again to the town and to the Select Board for trusting in us to host this great event.
Wonderful. Thank you. Selectman Wilson.
Yeah, really quickly, Mike. So they'll come from the beach up High Street. You're not doing Taylor Street. You're not doing the little stuff. You're coming up High Street, going straight onto Little River.
Correct.
No Mace Road, no side things, whatever. Just straight up Little River, up to Woodland.
Yep.
And that's going to be just a one-time shot?
One-time
shot. Circle the beach twice, then come over here. One-time
up. One-time shot up, and then we're done, we're done.
Okay. I was just, as I was looking at your sign, because I remember last year it said 8:20 to something, and that was just the beginning.
That was just the beginning, right.
You think this is a better estimate of the time when runners will be clearing?
Yeah, those signs were mostly for the road close time, which was during the big group. People out there for longer periods of time.
And I don't mean to insult people who run. It's nice that they run. Some don't run as fast as others, but nevertheless, you see the big pack go by, and then for the next couple of hours, you got people still in the road.
It'll be much quicker this time because there's no second group.
Okay, I like the signs. That's good.
If I'll just say one, I know our meeting's tomorrow to further go into our detail stuff. I would just also indicate there'd probably be more of a delay given the construction of the seawall project area on the South Pond return. So that'll slow things down a little bit for traffic in that area a little more than normal because of the amount of folk coming through. But just an FYI on that.
So you think that'll delay people enough so when they're going around twice, they might be later coming
they're
up?
They're not twice through that area. They'll only do the one loop through that section up through the southbound, right?
Just
the return on that. They'll be a little more spread out by then, but there will be an impact because we'll have to go down to one lane there for folks going through.
Also
so just
traffic,
for the public's knowledge.
Traffic ambassadors, people have maps for people out of the area to tell them how to get to Route 1 and get around it, which is the most frustrating thing. You're sitting there, I just like to get out of this. And so we have people at different places with maps for people as well.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Nothing. I think you guys do a great job, and good luck.
Thanks very much.
Mr. Fidel?
Yeah, great job planning, and it's great to have the activity. It's great to have people, you know, who are engaging in healthy exercise in town. It's a great group of people to have in town, and you do a great job. Thank you.
For the businesses in town, there are people from 40 states. There are over 4,600 people signed up so far, and two-thirds of them are from far enough away that they need to come and stay the night before and eat at all the restaurants. And so we're going to have a busy night, Saturday night and Sunday at the restaurants. So.
If I could just add my 2 cents also for this group, for all the groups we deal with at the police department, Mike and his crew are incredibly responsive. They're a great group to deal with and extremely well planned out when they come to us. So they make it a lot easier for us to deal with. So thank you.
If they eat at all the restaurants, they're going to run slower.
After they run.
That does happen.
Thank you very much, Michael.
They can eat after.
Roman 4, appointments. Number 3, Christy Pulliam, Finance Director, Alpha Monthly Financials.
Good evening, Christy.
Good evening. All right. right, I have the 8th report of 2014. The expenditure target is 66.7%. The month's total income was $595,000. Motor vehicles came in at $241,000, which is $19,000 above the monthly budget. The other major contributors to the month's total were building permits at $21,000, parking lots at $110,000, state water pollution control at $70,000, franchise fees at $61,000, departmental income at $36,000, and real estate trust at $53,000. At the end of August, the operating departments without debt service but with open POs were 76.79% of the budget, which is higher by almost $21,000 than the month's 66.7% target. The majority of the departments are below the target level and don't have any major issues. In finance, the postage account continues to run ahead of budget at 88.9%, and the registry of deeds is running above budget at 95.2%. So. In management information systems, the four equipment-related accounts have a combined budget of $81,000, and through August, 62.7% of these four accounts' annual budget have been spent. In personnel administration is now within the target budget at 64.91%, and you can also note in that section that the three New Hampshire retirement accounts are also within their budget. The planning board is running over budget at 80.3%, but when you combine this section with the Office of Planning, they are within their budget for a total of 55.6% if you add up all of their spending. In municipal insurance, it continues to run above budget or run over budget, but is related to payments made for the year for general liability insurance and workers' compensation. The police department is at 64.35% overall when you include the open POs. The fire department is at 63.71%. percent overall with open POs, and the four fire suppression OT accounts are at 55.2% of the annual budget. Highways and streets is at 71.3% with open POs, and municipal sanitation is running slightly above its target when you but that includes the $74,000 for the annual PO for chemicals. Maintenance of parks is over target at 72.3%, which is to be expected since we're closing in on the end of the summer season. They're almost done. Under warrant articles, the cost for the fifth of the 9 months related to CBAs was booked. I always get that one wrong. For the 2013 encumbrances, they're showing that 68% have been expended to date. And I will just note under there, I have had Diana in my office contacting each of the departments and going through all of the purchase orders for 13 and 14.
Yes.
And we're cleaning up that list. We got, since this report was done, we've liquidated a lot of purchase orders that were just kind of hanging out there.
Excellent.
So next month, I'm hoping that number shall drop for us. In the special revenue, or in the funds, Fund 24, the recreation for the beach sticker donations, the year-to-date equals $13,000, and $26,000 has been granted as scholarships for this year. The cable committee, the current fund balance is remaining slightly above last year's ending total. And private detail, activity level, income and expense has started to increase due to the time of year and better weather. So that is all I had for the August reports.
Thank you very much, Director. Appreciate it. Selectman Wilson.
Christy, since the public passed the sewer buy-in charge, and that's supposed to be segregated, I thought, as a separate fund to be used for wastewater, sewer expenses. Are we going to be actually setting up a fund here like EMS and recreation? Are we going to have a fund with a number so that we can see a report each month? How would we do that?
It's my understanding, talking to Fred, we're waiting to hear back from Mark, but it's my understanding that it will be set up similar to impact fees.
So we'll see a monthly accounting, because I don't...
I can give you guys a monthly accounting. I brought my spreadsheet again because I knew that you might ask. And we have $47,911 has been collected.
Okay, good.
So I can...
So the impact fees, Okay.
We haven't heard back from Mark yet on that, but Sam and I had talked, and it was our understanding by reading the policy and procedures that was set up that it would be handled in a similar way to impact fees. Mark, as we all know, has been a little busy, but it is on all of our radars.
Yeah, and this is new this year, and I appreciate that.
We are making sure we are keeping a close tally of it, and I also, when I reported on the income this month, I don't believe I did last month, but when I recorded on the income this month, I did subtract, because it is showing on your revenue as sewer permits, because that's where it's going right now. I did subtract that, though, so that the income that's reflected for the town is accurate.
Okay, so this is separate and independent, because the sewer connection fee is totally different.
Correct, and that's in here, and it's going in the sewer permit line where it always has gone.
Right. Okay, I appreciate that. Thank you, and it's nice to see the fund start growing.
Yes.
Selectman Brittle.
No, as always, you do an excellent job keeping our fund straight. We appreciate that.
Thanks.
Sir.
Yeah, the ones that are over, there's no problem with those, the ones you were talking about, the...
You mean like for the expenditures?
Yeah,
like, don't think so, because the only ones that were really over, besides finance, was highways and streets, and it has been running high all year because of all the snow that we had over the winter and stuff. But they're also, everyone's kind of quieting down now, so I think that everyone should be good.
Yeah.
Me? We'll see. Well, no more mails going out and no more registry of deeds trips.
Good.
Then we'll all be good.
Don't anticipate any big problems or anything. Everything looks smooth. Everything's running smoothly.
Being that it's my first year, but I am watching it, and it seems to be right in line with like last year at this time.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you, Director.
Yep.
Good night.
Oh, one more quick.
Yes, ma'am.
I appreciate you keeping on top of those. Great. The
tax impact.
Tax. Yeah. Well, not the the purchase orders that hang and hang and hang and hang. So I appreciate that, because I like to see it cleared out. I hate to see, especially 2013 items, dangling into the coming year.
Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Christy.
Have a good night.
Roman 5, approval of minutes 1, September 8, 2014.
I will be delighted to so move.
A second?
Second.
Any modifications, corrections? Seeing none, all those in favor? Unanimous? Roman 6, no new business has been listed or identified for the evening. Roman 7, old business?
Old business. Well, new business, old business.
Okay, if we're going to do new business, just a point of order so people can prepare, that needs to be articulated for the agenda. But go ahead, what is your new business?
Okay, well, I've been getting some feedback from residents north of Boar's Head, Boar's Head and the numbered streets. I did discuss this with Fred briefly, and he said that there was a possibility that the chief and he and we could perhaps get together and try to do something about keeping non-resident parking off the numbered streets. And I also had a resident that had, I thought, a nice idea, because people are coming in and parking anywhere. They avoid the state parking lot because they don't want to pay anything. And they get themselves squashed in the side streets, causing an awful nuisance. And you've addressed that before, for police and fire and emergency equipment. And the gentleman said, for example, and Boar's Head does have a big problem, that perhaps if, say, their father-in-law and mother are coming up for a week in August, that they might be able to go to the town clerk and apply for a weekly resident permit, $50, then they put the little sign in their car to show that they're not just tourists, they're here specifically visiting some residential person. And we could maybe control that way, a temporary resident parking thing. But I think we need to talk about this during the winter now, before we get killed again next year, whether it's resident parking on every other numbered street or something. This has got to be a pain in the neck for you. And the neighbors are really
I think there are two separate issues you're talking about there, but I had recommended previously, and I think it's a good idea, that we have a discussion related to the numbered streets.
Mm-hmm.
That is absolutely something that should be done. I have my opinions, but we should definitely open that up to a public discussion of what's good. Mm-hmm. It's a safety issue we need to address. Yeah. Boys had in the temporary visitor pass, essentially. That's a whole nother animal that
right.
I think we have to be very cautious as we move forward on that.
Well, Boar's Head, too, on the parking thing. And people are complaining, and I see this at North Beach, too, that individuals will come, and they'll dump their trash, and they'll do other things that I'm not going to mention on television and whatever in people's yards. And that's not the main beach, and that's not, it shouldn't be open pickings for people to just come and park and perch in there. So I'm hoping that we can get together with you and Fred now while it's off season to see if we can get a plan together.
Yeah, absolutely. I recommend it. I think that that's a public discussion that we have to get those folks in those
yeah,
areas
absolutely.
To be involved as well.
Absolutely.
Just going forward, and thank you for bringing that point up, Selectman Woolsey. We've got the town manager on vacation. We've got some scheduled surgeries. We're into budget. We'll probably have to double up on some meetings for some weeks so we can get that to the budget committee. But we can put that on a simmer and do that once we clear the budget hurdles. So
we have like the rest of the winter.
Exactly.
It doesn't have to be done before the budget.
Exactly.
But we need to resolve something for those poor people in those neighborhoods.
Thank you very much.
Old business.
Yes, sir.
The only thing I have is I want to remind people that with the construction on Route 1A,
yeah.
that if you have a Hampton sticker, you can park between 14th and 16th Street
yep.
on the state parking lot, and you will not get a ticket. The mm-hmm. state has given us the spaces there to use so that you don't have to worry about walking past parking the town parking lot and having to walk past it. You
yep.
can now park between 14th and 16th Street.
Mm-hmm.
And if you do have a problem and you have a Hampton sticker, give me a phone call and I will make sure we take care of it.
Well, just for now, so we've had discussions with the folks from the state that they're well aware of and planning to deal with that. If there's an issue, they can contact the police department. We'll help them out.
Selectman Waddell.
Yeah, just business. Reiterate what Rusty said on there. You know, and you can start south and walk south, and it's much safer to start south and walk south for yeah. the public. And it's just make the work go smoother, and the people will be able to do their work and everything, and just.
Yeah.
Because I know it's force of habit. People like yeah. to, but I've changed my yeah. routine and start south and walk south.
We absolutely recommend using that sidewalk. It's the safest way.
Yep.
Yeah.
The state has taken its position on how it's done, and we've tried to make that as safe as possible given all of the constraints. But absolutely, it's been a great thing to be able to, you yeah. folks going down to visit and have the state off yeah. the park down there. That's absolutely the best way to go.
My daughter hasn't complained yet, which is good.
Thank you very much. Roman A, closing comments? Seeing none?
My goodness, we're efficient this evening. Budget committee members brought this up briefly at their meeting, and I appreciate where they're coming from. And in the past, the budget committee has been eager to see warrant articles or potential warrant article proposals before they complete their work on the budget, and I appreciate that. We have a little pile now that Fred has put together, a wish list, hoped for, and I'd like us to have a chance one of these evenings to go through and discard from that pile, because some of that isn't going to fly. So I'd like to tackle that right up front, look at the warrant articles that he's been kind enough to put together as possibilities. And I'd like to go through that and discard stuff that we say there's no way, and then focus on getting possibly some of the other warrant articles, start feeding them into the budget committee, and so the public can see them.
That issue will be immediately following announcements in community calendar at the next meeting.
Appreciate that.
Thank you, ma'am.
Been diligently working on that list.
Mm. Thank you.
Because some of the stuff, look at it, and you're going to say, there's no way.
But again, that was options for you to discuss.
Yeah.
Thank you. Any other closing comments, closing remarks, a motion, any time?
I will so move, if the clock is working properly, that we adjourn this meeting at 7:31 p.m.
7:28.
All those in favor?
New technology, old technology.
Unanimous. Thank you very much. Good night.